Hi, everybody. How are you this evening? I hope you're having a great night. Tonight I get to go to work with babies for 8 hours. Oh, nothing like working with babies for 8 hours to warm my heart. So I'm in my Christmas attire. Yeah, I used to work with a ventilated adult, and now I get to work with children. Yeah, nothing like 8 hours of filling that heart full of love, especially when adults have been doing nothing but getting on my nerves for the last 2 weeks. Oh, yes. I cannot tell you how many come to Jesus meetings I've had to have with my mind and my mouth. Oh, yeah. It isn't like somebody gets on your good nerve, right? It's just like you go around and say, oh, you're on my good nerve today. Right. I believe there's three ways you can go about it. Number one, you can let it play itself out. Sometimes that's the best route to take. Number two, throw a little sugar, throw a little honey, some love, some diplomatic, you know, reasoning, that kind of thing, you know, a little stew of stuff, right? Just for the common welfare of another person. Or number three, you can just go all out Harry Carey, okay? And I try to stay away from Harry Carey because in my job, normally I have to deal with people who kind of use you as an emotional punching bag because they have been through everything. They've probably been through life and death. They have probably lost everything. They have probably just come to one of the worst points in their life. And so you just naturally expect to not only be their emotional punching bag, but also their advocator and their protector, and to love them as well. You know, you just have to be a really understanding person. Okay, but in my personal life, honestly, that's where I draw the line and have boundaries. And I'm not gonna be somebody's emotional punching bag ever, okay? Because this is how I will do. I will verbally KO you, and I don't even have to use foul language. No, I'm a good listener, and usually when people are acting up, it's usually because they're up to some funny business. Yeah, that's what I've learned. So, guys, we're going to talk about enough of my Chatty Cathy bleh stuff that I'm talking about here. Let's talk about eyeliner pencils. I've got so many. Look at that. So many of them. Oh. I don't even know where to begin, but we're going to talk about it. I'll probably have to do a 3 or 4 part video. I mean, when I say I've got black eyeliner coming out the yin-yang, this is just my black eyeliner stuff alone. So, let's get started. Okay, let's start off with pencil liners. We're going to start off with the 2, 4, 6, 7 that I have here that I've been using. I got one that's missing, actually, and it's one of my favorites. It's one I use all the time because it doesn't aggravate my eyes, okay? Because I wear contacts. Plus, I have naturally sensitive eyes. Anyway, so we're going to start off with Urban Decay's 24/7 Glide-On Eye Pencils. Now, I personally do not buy these pencils. I just keep getting them in kits, and I love that. And so I have quite a few of them, but I honestly do not care for them, okay? Because I will tell you why. One thing about these, I've had both Zero and Perversion. As a matter of fact, I have them both right here. They are sitting right in front of me, both of them. And you can see I've used them because sometimes I just grab for a black pencil. But the one thing about these, when I put them in my waterline, when I put them in my upper waterline, they seem to be okay, but they transfer. And when I put them in my waterline, they just seem to transfer everywhere and bleed. And they just, for some reason, they don't work for me. Now, I've heard people just rave about these, but then I've heard people say just the opposite. So that is my personal experience with these. They just don't work like a lot of people say they do, for me anyway, but for somebody else, they might. So leave me a comment. Let me know if you've tried the 24/7 Glide-Ons by Urban Decay and tell me what your experience is. By the way, guys, if you are on Google Plus, please come and see me, Sherielle Beauty. I would love to do some hangouts with you guys, maybe do some crackuccinos and some smack talk. God knows I love to do that. I know. I gotta pull myself in sometimes. Okay, we're gonna talk about Physician's Formula. These are the shimmer strips. They come like this, and they also come in the retractable. I like the retractable, so I like have them everywhere. They come like this. I don't have my black one somewhere, but they're like this. I love the retractables, and they come in a 3-pack for $11.99. Excellent deal. I get the one for hazel eyes all the time. Repurchase product. Now, the one thing about this, this type of style didn't really go over too well because you can break these really easy. But honestly, these were meant to be in the waterline, and they're supposed to be waterproof. And they're not necessarily waterproof, but they don't aggravate my eyes. Okay, and they don't bleed everywhere. That's one thing I can say about these. It isn't that they last a long time, but at least they don't transfer, and at least they don't bother my eyes. That's the one thing I can say about Physicians Formulas products, is that my eyes are really sensitive and their stuff does not bother my eyes. So I honestly use these. I have a whole bunch of them in black because I bought a bunch of kits, and I use them as cream bases, and I really like them. They're not bad at all, to be honest. Okay, NYX. See, we've got NYX Black Pencil right here. Now, NYX, to me, is this particular product doesn't necessarily bother my eyes, but and it doesn't transfer and bleed all over like some do, but it doesn't last either. Okay, it just doesn't last in the waterline. It's just one of those pencils that, if you know, if you're just carrying around, just a good all around, just keep applying it in the waterline. Now, my eye doctor told me that it is honestly better to not have waterproof eyeliners in your waterline, that it's better to keep reapplying it because it is aggravating to your eyes. And I personally have experienced it, so I do know. Okay, let's talk about something that really irks me about paying $20 or $25 for a liner pencil. And luckily for me, I get a discount because I have card. Okay, but for some people, they don't. All right, MAC. Okay, I have had Smolder and, let's see, what's the other one? Feline. Okay, and Teddy. Okay, all of these pencils, first off, don't even stay in the waterline. And if I'm going to just tightline in the upper waterline, they bleed right down into my lower waterline. I mean, they bleed instantly. Instantly. It doesn't, it's like, serious. So I don't even, it's crazy, but I don't even wear my MAC pencils because they are, look at, brand spanking new. I won't even wear it because it's, they're that bad, to be honest. If anybody else wears MAC eyeliner pencils and has these colors, please tell me if you have these experiences or if it's just me in my watery eyes that have this problem. Now, this here is the L'Oreal Carbon Pencil Perfect. Okay, it is retractable. It's very retractable. And this is a very soft liner pencil. Very soft. And you can smudge it really easily. The problem with this, once again, is that it is thick. It is very creamy. But it also transfers. It also smears into your eyes. And so, yeah, honestly, not a repurchase product. That's for sure. Now, I have a couple of these. I buy lots of kits of stuff just to try stuff, which I'm really happy that I do. Kits are a great thing. This here is the Waterproof Benefit Pencil, and you can see I have used it. I have two of these, actually. I got this in a kit with their Real Mascara and two of these pencils, which are pretty long. Let me see if I have my other one down here. Yep, there it is. They're actually pretty big. They look like this. Yeah. Anyways, I got it for $30 for all three. And I thought that was a great deal. Honestly, for benefit, those three items, I got these all for like 10. If you think about it, I got the Real Mascara and two of these, and I'm thinking $10 a piece. So it worked out pretty good, but honestly, not waterproof. But the one thing I can say is that this is one that you can keep reapplying, and it doesn't transfer all over the place. It pretty much stays where it's supposed to stay. So it really is really decent and pretty good for the upper lash line, and it has a smudger on the end, so you can actually smoke your eyes out real easy with this. So that is the nice thing about this. Now, I am trying to find my Milani Liquify because I've been using that a ton lately. And hang on one second, I'll be right back. I guarantee it's probably with my Physician's Formula. I went on a date night last night, and so all my stuff is in my makeup bag. I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. it went woo. I'm just throwing stuff everywhere. I had to go get my bag of tricks. This bag here gets, this is my makeup bag that I have in my purse. I've got one for the gym, one for my purse. Both of them sometimes go in the gym bag. Sometimes both of them go in my purse. Yeah, I have lots of bags. If you guys ever want to see what's in my bag, you guys will die. Because I use totes. Okay, purse totes, because I can't use a regular purse. It don't work for me. It doesn't work for me. So, yeah, don't use them. I use totes because, man, do I need a tote. Okay, I've got my Milani Liquify Liquid Light Pencil, and it is so soft. This is the softest liner pencil I have ever used, and this is 01 Black. This stuff, I have to say, I mean, it's so soft that every time you use it, you have to sharpen it. Because it dulls down that fast. And the one thing about this is that, man, when you get it into that top waterline, woohoo, look out. And then when you get it into the bottom waterline, it actually is really soft, and so it kind of spreads. But once it sets, it stays, okay? So you can work with it and smudge it out and work with it before it sets. The one thing about this pencil is that if you have contacts, it is really going to bother your eyes. One thing I noticed about this pencil is, yes, it does a lot of amazing things. I have to say, I really like this pencil, but the bottom line is that if you're wearing contacts, it will really bother your eyes. Little bits of it, while it's like setting, I guess, seem to like kind of creep into your eyes, and it can really be painful. So I have to say, I really think this is an amazing eyeliner, this Milani Liquify. And I believe it retails for about $8, $9, but you're going to go through it really fast. That's the only thing. So that concludes kind of, oh, and my physician's formula. I do not have it with me. It is somewhere because I use that one the most of all my pencils, and I'll tell you why. One thing I've noticed about, and I have a ton of them in all different colors. The reason that I love those pencils the most, let's see, which one is this? The reason that I love those pencils the most, honestly, is because one thing about Physician's Formula is the formula is very waxy. And so it's more of a waxy formula. So you definitely can't leave the lid off because it'll dry up that fast. But it's the retractable shimmer sticks. And they come in a three pack. They come in three packs. They come just like this with a black pencil. This one here, I can't remember which one this is for. But they got them for hazel eyes, brown eyes, blue eyes. And I get the hazel eyes because I use the one. Actually, I'm going through all my brow stuff. But I have so much brow stuff. I went and spent over $300 on brow stuff. You know what my actual favorite little ditty is? Is this darn e.l.f. dollar clear mascara and brow gel. And this darn pencil from the Hazel Pack. It matches my brows exactly. It isn't red. It isn't too orange. It isn't any of that. It matches perfect. It is the only pencil I have ever found that matches my brows perfect. What is it? $11 for three of these and a dollar for this, and I go and spend $300 on a bunch of expensive pencils. I went to MAC and bought their brow gel. I don't care for their brow gel at all. I've got it right here. I'm trying to find it. Yeah, I got a big brow bin. It's a brow bin. But yeah, this is it right here. I don't know why I'm bringing out brow gel. I need to get on track, but you know, I got a ton of those. Anyway, so that is for my pencil liners. Next, we are going to do, we'll do felt tip liners.